Well, I'm back, friends. This time with a really silly story. I think I read it a while ago. You might remember it. Anyhow, the title is If All the Animals Came Inside. The author who wrote the story is Eric Pinder. The illustrator, and you know what the illustrator does, he creates the pictures, is Mark Brown. Just try to think about things that could happen. If all the animals came inside, if all the trees came inside, I bet you can use your very smart brains to think of all of those things. But right now we're going to focus on if all the animals came inside. If all the animals came inside, my baby brother would cry. My sister would hide. There she is, covering up her eyes. The doggy would bark. Woo, woo, woo. The kitten would hiss. Hiss. My parents would make funny faces just like this. Wonder if those parents are worried about what would happen. But I wouldn't look for a place to hide. I'd climb aboard for an elephant ride. Can you pretend to be on an elephant ride? Thump, rump, bang, bump. The walls would tremble. The windows would shake. Oh, what a terrible mess we would make. But it looks like fun. When all the animals played hide and seek, I'd cover my eyes. But the monkeys always peek. Can you see this monkey peeking and this monkey peeking? And this one peeking? They'd laugh and they'd point. They'd swing and they'd run. I'd ride with a hippo and have so much fun. Crash, bash, zoom, and boom. Oh my goodness, I know you can say all of those words. The walls would tremble. The closets would quake. Can you quake? It's just like shaking. Oh, what a terrible mess we would make. Oh my goodness. I think he's really using his imagination. When all the animals wanted a snack, the skunk and the panda and even the yak would rush to the kitchen and chew up our food. Mommy would tell them to stop being rude. That is rude. Silly animals. Mom doesn't look too happy about it. Lunch, munch, burp, crunch. I know you can do all those things. I know you know how to have lunch. I know you know how to munch on snacks. Sometimes we burp and we say, excuse me. And sometimes we crunch on chips or goldfish. Well, guess what would happen? The walls would tremble. The dishes would break. Oh, what a terrible mess we would make. When all the animals needed a drink, they'd slobber and drool all over the sink. Ew. The badger would blubber. The grizzly would burp. My sister would mutter, "It's not nice to slurp." Phew, phew, whoo, ick, ew. Yuck. And the walls would tremble and the cupboards would shake. Oh, what a terrible mess we would make. Can you imagine the mess? The lions would roar as they sprawled on the floor. One, two, three. They have made themselves right at home, haven't they? The lemurs would lollygag right by the door. Does anybody know what lollygag means? It means to take so much time to get started to do something. They're just lollygagging away. My daddy would try to sit down in his chair. He'd holler and whoop with a porcupine there. Oh, what happened to his dad? Oh my goodness, I would not want to sit on a porcupine, would you? Would that ever hurt? Ow, wow, ouch, ouch, yelled my dad. And the walls would tremble, the sofa would break. Oh, I bet you can help me with this next line. Oh, what a terrible mess we would make. My goodness. The gibbons would giggle. Hyenas would laugh. Hee, 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 hee. The ostrich and I would go race the giraffe. We'd follow the bears as they ran up the stairs. We'd bounce on the beds and knock over chairs. Help me with this. Rumble, jumble, pounce and bounce. And guess what? The walls would tremble. The dressers would shake. Help me out here, friends. Oh, what a terrible mess we would make. At bath time, my daddy would stammer and stare. You can't take a bath with an octopus there. Oh my goodness, can you imagine? The faucet would leak. The bathroom would flood. I wonder why the bathroom would flood. Can you think about that, friends? Daddy would slip and he'd land with a thud. Splish, splash, slip, splat. And the walls would tremble, the toilet would shake. Oh, what a terrible, help me out, mess we would make. Looks like he's having fun, though, with the octopus in the tub. He has quite the imagination. When all the animals wanted to play, they'd grab all my toys. They'd take them away. Uh-oh. Upstairs and downstairs and out in the hall, the chipmunks would draw with my paint on the wall. Look at these chipmunks. They think the wall might be an easel. Mm-mm-mm. Wibble, scribble, wipe, and swipe. And guess what, friends? The walls would tremble. The crayons would break. Oh, no. Oh, what a terrible mess they would make. We don't like broken crayons, do we? And we do a lot of art in our classroom. Oh, there are some bats. The bats would be dealing my cards on the ceiling. Oh my goodness. The squirrels would be squealing. The paint would be peeling. Can anybody find a diamond in any of these cards? Or can you find some hearts on these cards? Can you imagine cards on the ceiling? The rhinos downstairs would be watching my TV. They'd stand in the way and leave no room for me. Now that is not very nice. That is what I would call rude. Oh my goodness. Spilling the popcorn and causing a riot. Whooping and snorting. They would never be quiet. This is quite the adventure. Every last creature would sleep in my bed. Oh my goodness. With oodles of pillows, one for each head. I wonder how many pillows that would be. Let's count the animals since they each have a pillow. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. We have to include them. Nine pillows. My goodness. That's a lot of pillows in the bed. From sunset to sunrise, the wolves and the owls would keep us awake with their hooting and their howls. Hoot, hoot. We'd have nowhere to sleep, so we'd stretch and we'd yawn. Oh, we'd pack up our tent and go play on the lawn. Who is now in their house? They're not. All those animals came inside. As fun as a house full of critters could be, my dog and my kitten are really plenty for me. But oh, what a wonderful and wild ride when all the animals came inside the